All of us know that the climate change has a direct effect on crop adaptation and yields due to the changing higher temperature, extreme events and water availability. And the climate change is a real problem for a lot of food crops. If you look only to the water availability, the water scarcity will be a direct effect on yield production. But for other kind of crop like grape wine, this water scarcity in some places could be an opportunity to improve the grape quality on the basis of the relation between water stress and grape quality. All of us know that the concept of terroir is strongly based on the interaction between plant, soil and climate in order to produce a specific condition able to achieve a specific wine quality, then grape quality responses wine quality. Then climate change could be change this interaction and then also producing an improvement or worsening in grape quality expected. But I will try to explain my idea starting from the how normally the people works to evaluate the crop responses to climate change. Normally the research uses simulation modeling and climate change scenario obtained from a global, at a global scale and after downscaled to a specific site, producing a weather data set that are used in input in the simulation modeling in order to obtain crop responses in terms of above ground biomass, yield production and nitrogen uptake. Then the type of results that we arrive and the quality depend on the system knowledge in terms of how your model describes the system and also if your model is calibrated or not. And it's really important the quality of input data. And this application work at different spatial scale, and on the basis of different spatial scale we can consider explorative scale like a global macro scale and meso, and also operative scale when we work at the farm scale. If we look to the grape wine quality, the question is that the grape quality, the forecast of grape quality is a challenge. It's not easy for the model to arrive to say something about the grape quality. Then in order to predict the grape quality responses on Aglianico grape wine, I used an hydrological indicator that represents the plant water status, namely crop water stress index. It is an indirect approach to derive to obtain the grape quality expected. Why I used this index? Because in literature there are a lot of works that tell us that there is this link between water stress and grape quality. And also this link was validated inside of this work. The methodology proposed is based on three steps. The first one was the simulation model evaluation. The model was calibrated and validated. And after, from the output of the model, this hydrological indicator was correlated to the plant responses in field in terms of grape quality. And different thresholds for the crop water stress index was identified for different grape quality. After these two steps, a future climate scenario was used to forecast a crop water stress index and then grape quality responses in the future for the Aglianico grape wine in our study area. The study area is a farm of southern Italy. The data collected was collected during a regional project Zovis on zoning at the farm scale on Aglianico cultivar, standard clone population planted in the 2000. And it's interesting that the whole thing that regards to the viticultural zoning was published last year on Soil Journal. Here I will show you some information about the soil. In this study area, we have done the pedagogical survey supported by geophysical survey. We have done a different profile and engineering. We have identified two representative soil of our study area, a cambisol and a calcisol. What is interesting to say that normally the people that work in viticulture give more emphasis to the soil texture. Okay, clay soil, sand soil, etc. But in this case, we have two soil that are classified as in same way, as a clay loam texture. But if we go to the measure the hydraulic properties of different soil horizon, we obtain that these two soils have very different behavior in terms of how manage the water, and then the water is available for the plants. And just an example about the available water content in the first 18 centimeter in the camisole, we have 145 millimeters of available water content compared to 18 millimeters in the calcisole. During the project, we have for 3 years we have monitored the soil in terms of water content, and we have used also tensiometers, and we have monitored the crop and the climate Look at the first step of this procedure. The model of slope was validated and calibrated and validated on 2 years, 2011-2012, for the soil water balance. Here is reported only in one figure that shows how we have done the calibration in the first 1 meters. Then we have a different soil depth in which we compare the soil water content estimated by the model and measured in field. And the model has showed a good agreement between the data estimated and measured in field. We have determined then, after we have calibrated the model, validated this index, crop water stress index, that is a ratio between actual transpiration and potential transpiration, and we have compared this information with the leaf water potential that we have measured in field. The idea was to understand if this index really can say something about what the plant has felt in field, and we have identified a good correlation, significant correlation. On the right, you can see two figures that represent the crop water stress index simulated by the model and the leaf water potential measured in field. In blue line are reported the data of the calcisol, and red the camisole. And it's clear that these two soil with the same plant, with the same climate, because we work in 70 meters, have a very different behavior that have not only with the leaf water potential, but also in other parameters that I'm not sure on the physiological behavior of the plant. And after this, the second step was to try to correlate this index to the grape quality. We have for 2 years collected information of 13 characteristic of bunches. We have identified in these 2 years for both soil positive and negative correlation. Positive for the sugar color intensity, total anthocyanins and pH, and negative correlation on titrable acidity, color hue, and total tannins in the grape skin. This was done during the season, the correlation between the index and the evolution of these parameters of bunches. What I've done also was the correlation between the crop water stress index cumulated during the growing season and the grape quality, and we have identified five linear correlation between tannins in the skin, just for example, and flavans in skin, sugar, anthocyanins, and color intensity. All this data, all this relation, say us that the crop water stress index can help us to say something about the grape quality. And then the problem is we have to move to translate this information in grape quality classes. And we have done it, identifying four classes of grape qualities from literature: ultra quality grapes, standard and well processed quality grapes, and low quality grapes, and the characteristics from literature for Aglianico grape wine of 12 bunches characteristics. We have identified the range for each of these grape quality classes. With this table, we are able to compare our data collected in 3 years of data monitored in field with this table, and obtain then the threshold of crop water stress index able to reach a different grape quality classes. For the three, in particular, ultra standard well was considered the same, and the low quality grapes. We introduced another class that was ultra quality grapes with uncertainty when this index go over over the value that we have identified in field, because we don't know what will happen really on the grape quality when the stress go up on 15%. Just to say that during the 3 years of monitoring, the Calcisol produced 1 year ultra quality grapes and for two years standard quality grapes, while in the Campisol we have two years with the standard quality grapes and 1 year with the low grape quality. Then we move at the third step of this procedure. Then we have the model calibrated. We have identified the ratio between the relation between crop water stress index and grape quality for Aglianico 1. Then we have used a future climate scenario in our model calibrated to set something on behavior of grape quality in these two soil in the future. The data of future climate change was 15 equiprobable years representative of period 2021-2015, and these data were produced during an Italian project on crop adaptation to climate change, agro scenario project, and here I reported the behavior in these 15 years of crop water stress index in these two soil, in blue for the Calcisol and red for the Campisol, and with the dotted line you can see the average value during the 3 years of monitoring. What has happened that in the Calcisol we in the future will have an increase of 47% of this stress, and Campisol only of 32%. But in terms of grape quality, what happens that the Calcisol remain in its position of the best terroir in terms of soil plant atmosphere system, because the 13% of probability is to produce ultra quality grapes, and in part 46% with the uncertainty, and the Campisol remain as a soil or terroir that is able to produce a standard grape quality, but there is a little percent of 18% of probability to produce an ultra grape quality. This is this means that in comparing this the 3 years of monitoring that the Campisol move versus ultra grape quality, the reduction in water in the future is good for this kind of soil for the Aglianico, and while for the Calcisol there is an improvement of uncertainty. The conclusion is that the results seems to confirm the potentiality of use of the simulation model of physical business simulation model to say something about viticulture or terroir behavior, and it's interesting that we have validated this relation between crop water stress index produced by the model and the crop responses. It's important to stress that obviously this kind of approach was realized on Aglianico in a specific case study where we was lucky to have the same plants. We work in the same climate with the two very different soil, but it's not. We have to think that this correlation are for Aglianico, and they cannot be generalized to the other grape wine without any calibration, validation, etc. And it's also interesting to say that the concept of terroir is resilient in the Calcisol compared to the Campisol, and in the field of condition seems for the Campisol in our study area and in our future climate scenario an opportunity for the Campisol. Thanks for your attention.